Hello students, this is Aisha. We are studying IGCSE ICT practical revision. Today we will do unit number 14 styles. So in unit number 14 we will discuss about how to use master slide for consistent styles, creating a new style in word processing software, applying a paragraph styles, modification of existing styles, and widow and orphan concept. So let's start with the first one. First of all, why we need the consistent style? Basically, we have some terms over here. First is corporate branding. It's a promotion of a company or organization through the advertising style it uses. The more people see the style, the more they associate with that particular company or organization. Okay, for you are just creating your brand, so what you will do? You will just make the consistent style of all that, so that they can associate that particular style with your company or organization. Second is house style. House styles mean the elements in the corporate documents that create a sameness in the documents of the company. Okay, that elements that create the sameness in all the document of the company, that is called your house style. Third is consistent style. Promotional material with the same color, same style, same logo position on all documents. All documents, just like for example, if you are making a website, if you are just giving some pamphlets over there, or presentation, or any other documents. So all material should have the same style, same color, same logo position. So all the promotional material should have consistent style. Okay, it should not be just one is in blue color, one is in red color with the different font, and for one logo is at the top, for one logo is at the bottom. So there should be a consistent style in all types of document. Let's continue with the styles. How to apply styles to ensure consistency of presentation? So first of all, it's related to the presentation. So I'm opening any presentation software. Just a minute, I'm making the new file. Okay, so if you want to make a consistent style, what you have to do, first of all, go to view menu and click on the slide master. Okay, slide master. Click over here, you will get this now. Click on the very first slide. Now change the settings which you want to be consistent in all the slides. Okay, which you want to be consistent in all the slides. You can choose the themes, ready-made themes from here. Otherwise, you can start your own curling style. Suppose I am just choosing this one. According to that, you can choose the fonts. It's for the Office, Office 2, means for Calibri. Look here now in the preview, it is going to be changed. So select the font according to your own requirement, based on the audience. Okay, based on the audience, based on the type of your document. Select the font. After that, you can have the background styles. From the font, let's suppose I have chosen this one, or any other style you can choose. Let me change some colors over here. So according to the colors, you will have the different background styles. Okay. After that, you can add any, for example, you want to add your logo. Okay. Go to insert. So in the slide master, you will insert your logo. It will apply in all the slides. Insert, go to picture. Select any picture. Suppose I have selected this one. Okay, just resize that picture and choose the position. Either you want it at the top of every slide, either you want it at the bottom of every slide. So choose the position and make it consistent for all the documents. Okay, after that, if you want to appear a company name in all the slides, go to insert. You can insert a text box. Suppose I want a company name over here or with the logo. Just click over here, company name, and select the position. Then if you want page number, sorry, slide numbers, footers, so go to insert menu, headers and footers. If you want to appear date and time, click over here. Update automatically means whenever you will open that file, the date will be automatically updated. So if you want fixed date, you can just choose for the fixed one. It will not update automatically then. Okay, I am not applying the date and time. Slide numbers, it will appear over here. footer, if you want to write anything about the footer, suppose mostly they write about the title, okay, what is your presentation about. So I'm just writing topic of presentation. Don't show on title slide, main slide is usually different, so I will check this one, don't show on title slide. After that I will click on apply to all. Apply to all mean all the slides which I will create, this one this format will be applied to all the slides. Apply to all. Even if you want to change the color of this text color for the headings, go to home tab. So in the master slide I am just changing the colors, I am making it bold, I am just changing the color, suppose any color you can choose, suppose this one, okay. So in the master slide I have done these changings. After that click over here, if I have done everything, second level heading, third level heading, if you want to change the font of that you can change that. For example, third level setting, second level heading you want to change the bold, italic or anything, any formatting if you want to do, paragraph spacing, text duration, alignment text. So after doing that click on the slide master and click on close master view. Close master view, when you close master view, look here now, for the first slide company name here, logo here, and the font color is changed for the title. If I am going to insert the new slide over here, look, automatically company name is here, logo is here, topic of presentation is here, add title font is changed, background images which we have selected for in slide master. Again I am inserting a new slide, so again, so this will be consistent for all the slides, even the font styles, font means colors, so everything you can adjust it in master slide. And better to do it at the initial before making the presentation, it will be easy for you. So this is how you can create the master slide. After that, now what type of documentation can be there for the business, for the companies? Normal documentation, there might be letterhead, there might be fact sheets, forms, invoices, receipts, sales slips. And if you are going for the online documentation may consist of web pages, forms, surveys, forums, blogs. So there can be different types of documentation, but what you have to decide, you have to decide about the consistent style, the house style that should be same, okay, in all the things. If you are using a color font, for example blue and orange you want to choose, so choose for all of them. Font style, font face, it should be same for all type of documentation, either it is online or the normal document. Next, appropriate style including font type, serif and sans serif. Serif and sans serif, basically these are the two types of font. This one, look here now, this, look at this picture. This is your serif style with these edges. So there are many fonts available with these edges, so these are called serif styles, and without these edges this is called sans serif. Okay, so different styles are available, only major two types are there. So how to change all these things, font size, font color, alignment, point, let's open the word processing software. This is just a normal text, I have just copied it, so just to show you how to do the changes. So these are the font styles, but you want to make it consistent for all that. Some styles are predefined, available over here, you can choose from here also, or if you want to create your own, you can create your own also. Okay, for first of all I am choosing the predefined styles. So how to choose that, if you go to view, click on the outline. In the outline view you will just get the text, no images will be there, you will just get the text, so you can easily do the formatting over there. Okay, if you have a long document, for example for this one I want this one to be level 1 heading, I want this one to be level 2 heading, this should be level 3 heading. Okay, again this should be level 3 heading, so just you can select it from here, this should be level 2 heading. So this is a one way you can apply the heading styles over here. I am closing the outline view. After doing all this formatting you can close the outline view. Secondly, for the paragraphs, for the normal text, even you can choose the styles. Look here now, automatically changes are done. So for the main text automatically you can choose it from the predefined styles, or you can modify that one. Suppose I have selected this one, is in the main text. This is the format of main text now, or line spacing, paragraph spacing. If you want to modify this, just right click over here, click on modify. Right click on the normal text and click on modify. This is your main text. Suppose I want this font to be Arial, okay. I want this left line, okay. Less paragraph space, line spacing, reduce the paragraph spacing. So look here now, changing. If you can see the preview, it's Arial 11 point, line spacing single, space after auto. So if you want to apply only for this document, check this one. On new document based on this template, then select this one. I'm just doing it only for this document. Click OK. So changes will be made in this. Now, if you want to create your own styles for all the main body, what you have to do? You can click over here. Click on Save Selection as a new quick style. Save Selection as a new quick style. Just write the name of the theme. Let's suppose Test Layout. Okay. Now, how you want to appear to be paragraph? Click on the Modify. These are the different options available here. Suppose I want a body should be for Times New Roman. Font size for whole body should be 12. Okay, automatic and line spacing. Okay. Then click on the Format tab, Fonts. You can change from here also. Font color, let's suppose, should be blue. Look here at the preview, okay, and click OK. From here, you can go for paragraph line spacing. Line spacing, it should be suppose 6 point before and 6 point after. This is paragraph spacing, and line spacing suppose 1.5. Okay, and click on OK. After applying these different formats, what you have to do? Click on OK. Now, whatever you will select, this will be assigned over here now. Our theme name was Test Layout. I am just going to select this one and clicking on Test Layout. Automatically, all the settings will be applied. So, this is the best way to choose the styles and create your own styles for your particular documentation. Other way, just for one thing, suppose I have changed this detection level heading to color to red and underline also. The second way is you can choose the Format Painter tab. Format Painter, but if you have only few things, then you can go for Format Painter, but if you have a long text over here or long documentation, better to go for Styles. Format Painter, what it will do? It will do all the formatting just like this. Suppose I am selecting this one, this one. So all the formatting is changed, underline, italic, font color, everything is changed now. So how you have to do? First select the style which you want to copy. Click on the Format Painter and select the style which should be changed. This is how it is going to be changed. So, we have done use of master slide, creating a new style, applying a paragraph styles. So, for the paragraph styles, modification of existing styles we have already done. For the paragraph styles, you can click on the paragraph tab over here, select the paragraph first. Suppose I am going to the next page. Select the paragraph, click on the paragraph tab over here, default alignment, it is left alignment. So, if you want to choose center alignment, you can go for that, right alignment, justified. Mostly the documents are justified. Justified means balance from the left and the right side. Okay. If you can see the preview, let me show you. If you are going to do it justified, it will be balanced from, look here now, from the left and right side. Okay, what else you can do with the paragraph? You can select the paragraph spacing before and after. You can set this line spacing. Suppose double I am doing this one. Click OK. Double line spacing, paragraph spacing with the justified option. This is how your paragraph will look like. So, from this menu you can change your paragraph formatting. There is one more concept, is widow and orphan. Widow and orphan mean, sometimes what happens if you are writing a paragraph, only one line is at the end on the next page. That line is we call it term a widow. Okay. And sometimes it happens that only one line is at the beginning and the rest of the paragraph is on the next page. And that is called orphan. So, to deal with that widow and orphan, what you have to do, again go to paragraph formatting. click on line and page breaks, select this one, widow and orphan control, automatically it is selected. So select this one if this type of problems are there. If you will select that, it will automatically adjust that one. Click on OK. So we have done all this. That is all for unit number 14. If you have any question, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you very much for listening.